Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, we are going to discuss about support process in Salesforce. So if you want to follow Salesforce training videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube and you can follow my YouTube channel. So now coming on to the topic. So now you are going to learn how you can create support process in Salesforce. So first I'm opening service app that is already available in Salesforce. So on service app, you will see a tab that is case. So I'm clicking on case tab. Now I'm going to open all open cases. So here you will see various cases are available. So I'm opening a case. So this is a case record. So here you will see in the details section, a pick list value or pick list field is available, that is status. So if I click on this pencil, so you will see values available in this pick list. So right now it is showing three values, new, working and escalated, right? Now moving to setup. In object manager, I'm searching for case object. Now I'm searching for the field that is status. So here you will see four values are available, new, working, escalated and closed. So right now this record is having only three values. So now our requirement is to create record types for this case object, right? So we create record types so that we can control pick list values. For one record type, we want some set of values that are available in pick list. For another record type, we want another set of values, right? So we can control pick list values with the help of record types. So let's create record types for case object. So if I click on new, so you will see a message is available here. It says a case record type must be associated with a support process, right? So it means before creating any record type for case object, you need to create support process. And further, the statement is you currently do not have any active support processes. You must create a support process before creating the case record type. So now you might be thinking what support process is. So friends, we have status pick list on case object. And whenever you want to control values of that status pick list, then you need to create support process. And after creating support process, you can link that support process with record types, right? So you can create support process by clicking on this link that is here. And also you can go to setup, like from here. And here you can search support processes. Right, so here we need to create support process for case object. So I'm creating first support process, name is demo. So this is demo one support process. I'm clicking on save. So now it will open status pick list. So here you can see case status pick list is available here. So for demo one, I am selecting these three values, new, working and closed. And default value will be new, right? So this is my first support process. Now I'm going to create one more. So this will be demo two. And for this demo two support process, I am selecting all four values, right? So this way I categorized status pick list in two different ways. One support process is having only three values of status pick list, and another one is having all four values. So now we are going to create case record types so that we can use these support processes. So this time, if I try to create record types, so you will see it is not throwing any warning, like you don't have any support process because we created. So case demo one, this is first record type. I am using demo one support process. You can fill description as per the requirement. So case demo one record type. Then I am right now enabling this record type for all the profiles. Then you can also select a particular layout. So I'm selecting case layout. You can select different layouts for different record types. Also, you can select different layouts for different profiles as well. So these things you can do. And if you want to learn more about these things, so you can watch a video related to record type and profile on my channel. So now I'm clicking on save. So here you can see record type demo, case demo one is created, support process is demo one. Then here you can see pick lists available for editing. So friends, remember, you can control only status pick list with support process, but rest of the pick list you can control directly by record types. So here all available pick lists are showing. You can click on edit and you can change or you can manage the values of pick list for this record type. Now I am creating second. So this is case demo two. For this, I am choosing demo two support process. I am clicking on active so that it will be available. I am enabling this for all profile. So both the record types will be available for all profiles. I am selecting same layout for this record type as well. So you can change it as per the requirement. Clicking on save. So here also you can see record type is case demo two, support process demo two, and rest pick lists are available for editing. So these we can control with the help of record type. So only status pick list we need to control with support process. Others we can control with record types. So now you can see I have created two record types. And for these two record types, I created two support processes as well. Now I'm refreshing the page so that these record types and support processes will pop properly. So now I'm going to create new record for case. You can see both record types are available, case demo one, case demo two. So if you remember for case demo one record type, we chose demo one support process, right? And in demo one support process, we selected only three values, new, working, and closed, right? So it is showing a new and working. Now, I am saving this. So on this record, if I click on this button, so you can see only two values, closed is not available. So you need to make some changes in the support setting so that this will be available. So I'm moving to home. And from here, I'm selecting support settings. So if you want to show closed status pick list value, so you need to click on support setting, then click on edit, scroll down, and here you will see a checkbox which says show closed statuses in the case status field. So check this checkbox, click on save. Now, do a refresh so that these changes will be applicable. So now if I click on edit, so you can see new, workaround, closed, all three values are available. So this way you can populate closed status as well. So you need to make changes in support settings. So here various other options are also available. So you can go through with support setting if you want to enable any other setting. Now I'm going to create another case record that is for case demo 2. So here you will see all four values are available. It is also including escalated. So for a demo 1 support process, we selected only 3 values. For demo 2 support process, we selected 4 values. And our case demo 2 record type is using demo 2 support process. So that's why all 4 values are available. So this way we used support process for creating case record types and to control status pick list of case object. Remember that a support process only controls status pick list of a case object. If you want to control other pick list, that you can do through with record types only. So this is all about support process in Salesforce. I hope you understood whatever I demonstrated in this video. If you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube and you can follow my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this video.